What's up, guys? Welcome to Rockin' the Country. Well, like, I'm just happy to have everybody here. Subscribers, non-subscribers, lurkers, everybody just getting into country music. And it's a worthwhile cause, this country music journey that we're on. I'm doing a subscriber request today, and it's of an artist that I had not heard of, Bobbie Cryner, right? And I'm doing a song, You Think He'd Know Me Better, off her 1996 album, Girl of Your Dreams. And that Tom Patrick requested this song, and just recently, and I'm like, based on what you said, Tom, I'm like, I gotta bump this one up the list. And she only released two albums. She's a singer-songwriter, and so that's her deal. She did two albums in the 90s, and apparently they were very good, but that's all she did. And she was born in Woodland, California, so she's a Westerner doing country music. And I got the feeling that it's like Texas country, even though I haven't heard this. So that's the deal. So Bobbie Cryner's song, let's see, You Think He'd Know Me Better. All right, so this could make me feel bad. Maybe she's going to talk about stuff I do. I don't know. I hope not. I'm trying to pay attention. All right, here we go. Almost has like a Mexican type feel to it. Mariachi. I sat
there talking to myself. Why can't he turn it down? He keeps that TV up so loud that I can't think. And every time I turn a page, he starts to talk about his day. Can he see I'm trying to read?
Okay, real quick. Two artists immediately popped into my mind. Reba McEntire, and now I just lost the other one. But who she sounds like, I'll get it back. But Reba, I heard some flares of Reba, and then a more contemporary artist. But God, it was on the tip of my tongue. I'll get it.
And it's cold enough in here to freeze.
Carly Simon.
Keeps it 68 degrees. What's that man been thinking?
Let's see where this goes.
He does. I sat there wondering to myself why he wears those same old clothes. With any sense, he knows they're out of style. And damn that man, why can't he tell? I'm dying in this house.
You gotta get out, man.
And can't he tell what mood I'm in? The way I've got my back to him, I don't feel like making love. In all the years we've been together, you'd think he'd know me better.
All right, now I'm thinking a lot of things in this too. That's classic, in many ways, classic man-woman things. Like, we guys are very simple, and we need you to tell us a lot of stuff. I mean, as we get older, we're able to figure it out, assuming we want to figure it out. So I'm speaking from experience where it was like, wow, I was just clueless about what women wanted, what they paid attention to, how the minds work, the rambling thoughts that go on in there, but just some of the, you know, things that I had to figure out by making mistakes, and I did. But I also know that, like, as much as I'm paying attention, I still know that, like, it helps if you tell us, like, women. It helps if you tell me. It helps if you tell the guys. And then if he's not getting it or not listening or doesn't care, you got a real problem. But it's kind of a two-way street on that one. Like, you know, if you want to go out or if you want him to dress better, like, I started dressing, you know, probably about fifth year of marriage. I don't know. I was about 30 years old, 32. I look back at pictures and I was dressing like frumpy. Like the jeans I had just were these baggy things and the shirts weren't fashionable. And I love fashion, but still somehow. And she called me out. She pointed it out like, Don, you got to get some new stuff. And so we go out and she kind of dressed me up, right? And I'm like, oh, these jeans do look a lot better when they're like kind of like custom fit, so to speak, or the shirts, you know. So all that said, some of that's a matter of finances, but all that said, you got, ladies got to tell us too. And then if we're ignoring it, then that's an issue. But there you go.
And he does. I sat there.
That's a problem.
He knows his supper's waiting on the store. And I sat there lying to myself about the suitcase in the hall. And the night I heard him call her on the phone.
That's a big problem.
He said he'd been thinking to himself how I've treated him like hell. In all the years we've been together, you'd think he know me better than he does. In all the years we've been together, why don't he know me better than he does?
Wow. That's a seriously sad song. And the reason why it's so sad is because that stuff goes on every day. Relationships don't work out. And it sometimes comes down to communication, sometimes just wrong chemistry. Marriage is a hard thing, but man, that's a harsh, harsh reality because he's saying the same thing to her, you know? Like in the beginning of the song, it was like she's reading her book and can't he tell she wants to be left alone? And da-da-da-da, so it's like, all right, he's not paying attention to her needs. Sometimes we need downtime, private time. And I kind of thought this was going to be a song where the dude was just a schmuck, you know, just not a good, you know, whatever. But then it turned out, I don't know if she realized she had it, you know, he felt the same way toward her. Like, how could you not know, you know, what I need? I need you to talk to me more and all that. So who's at fault here? Nobody from this song. I mean, relationships are just hard things, especially when they break up like that. So, boy, oh, boy. Like, she's a talented singer. She delivers the lines well. The music was just sort of like almost like a waltz, but you could never even dance to this because you just want to cry. Oh, gosh. I'm not, am I going to punk out and not rate this thing? I'll rate it. I'll give it a rating. I'll take the bold step for mankind. I'm going to give it an 8.3. And a sad song could be like, I mean, Miranda Lambert's song, I think, was the highest I rated one. Like, Love Your Memory, I think, was the highest one at like a 9.6. That's a sad-ass song. But, man, did it just covered, it hit what they meant to hit. And this song, you know, did that too. Yeah. So, all right. Well, there it is, Bobbie Cryner. I'm going to be doing some more stuff. Tom Patrick, that was for you, my friend, and for everybody else. Maybe some of you guys know who Bobbie Cryner is. Only did two albums, so there's not a lot for me to choose from as far as follow-up songs, but eventually I hope to get to another one of hers. So there it is, guys. Love your man, love your woman. Talk, communicate, smile, laugh, go dancing. Look, dress decently if you can. Don't have that mustard stain on your shirt, fellas, too. I mean, we do look ridiculous sometimes, and we got to pay a bit more attention to that. So, all right, guys, there it is. Hit that subscribe button if you're into it, and I'll see you on another video. Keep rocking the country.